Gravity is a natural phenomenon through which all objects with mass or energy are drawn together. On Earth, we see gravity as the force that pulls everything back down to the ground. But that's because the planet itself has a lot of mass and energy, so everything is pulled toward it. The universe as a whole is affected by gravity. As it draws suns, planets, and galaxies, it determines how they are structured around one another. On Earth, we're affected by the gravitational pull of other objects, such as the moon. The moon can control the tides with its gravitational pull. Let's get back to the main question. Can gravity's influence last forever? Unfortunately, the answer is somewhat complex. There are two possible answers to this question, depending on whom you're speaking to. This is because there are two possible scientific theories to consider. Newton's law of universal gravitation reveals that the force of gravity exerted on one mass by another mass depends on their separation. As you get farther away from a gravitational body such as the Sun or the Earth, the gravitational pull on you weakens, but never completely disappears, at least according to Newton's law of gravity. By Newton's law, gravity should indeed be infinite. There's a relationship between the force of gravity experienced by one mass and the distance between them. Newton's law applies well to closer distances, and it's very easy to use within our galaxy since the gravitational pull between masses never diminishes. The same is true inside our planet, as we have already experienced. In other words, people who answer yes to the question, "Does gravity exist forever?" believe in Newton's theory. The problem is, Newton's theory is wrong. That's when Einstein comes into play. Currently, the most accurate theory of gravity is not Newton's law, but rather Einstein's general theory of relativity, which includes the cosmological constant. According to general relativity, gravity is not a direct classical force. Our concept of gravity refers to the way objects move within curved space-time. Space-time behaves depending on how much mass and energy is present, how it's distributed, and how it's moving. Einstein's general theory of relativity explains how space-time behaves as a whole, because it depends on the amount of mass and energy present, its distribution, and its motion. According to this theory, gravity isn't a force exerted by one mass on another, but rather simply how objects move through space-time, which is curved. By this method, a large astronomical body, such as the Sun, doesn't send out gravitational force field lines to trap other bodies. As the mass moves, it bends space and time around itself, and when another body travels through this warped space-time, it's affected by its force. Within planets, solar systems, galaxies, and even galaxy clusters, there is enough localized mass that makes it appear that objects are gravitationally attracting one another. Because they're close enough to each other, all the masses are moving through each other's warped space-time. In this sense, Einstein's theory of relativity works almost the same way as Newton's law of gravity on smaller scales. Due to its simplicity, Newton's theory is what most people will choose. Masses of astronomical objects at large distances are too sparse and far apart to act like Newton's gravity would. Space-time is virtually empty at such large scales, with barely any warping. As a result, objects don't come into contact with each other's force and are not affected by each other. They move further away from each other instead of towards each other. Similarly, two galaxies that are too far from each other to enter each other's space-time will move further and further apart. But why? Einstein's theory accounts for this with a cosmological constant. According to this theory, when space-time is empty, uniform, and flat, it expands. As galaxies distance themselves from one another, they move faster and the universe expands faster. This is known as the cosmic expansion. Once the different masses are too far apart to influence one another, gravity no longer takes effect. According to Einstein's theory of relativity, gravity does not extend indefinitely. Einstein's general theory of relativity is much more complex than Newton's, but it's currently the most accurate theory about gravity because it considers more factors. By scientific standards, the answer to this question should always be no. Gravity's influence does not extend indefinitely. Gravity extends up to between galaxy groups, but beyond that, the universe becomes too empty for different masses to interact. The influence of gravity only extends to the edges of each gravity group. Beyond that point, space-time no longer behaves like gravity. When a star leaves a galactic cluster, the star's gravitational attraction doesn't get weak, it goes away completely. Space-time simply does not behave at all like attractive gravity on cosmic scales. Because of this, gravity does not extend beyond gravitationally bound groups of galaxies. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.